really good. It's your boy Ty with the Red Widow. Man, I've been trying to get out the Wham all day, bro. I don't know if I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna try. I had so much going on. My son had a football game. My boy got a birthday party. You know, I'm like, bruh, everything in the world. None of these people own Mopar, so they don't get it. They don't understand the need to be out at Wham, but damn, I'm trying to get out here. So we're gonna see if we can sneak out there. It's an hour away from where I'm at, so we're gonna try to sneak out there. Then sneak to the party. Then sneak back out there. If we can do that. But keep in mind, it's an hour away each time. Yeah. So just stay tuned. We're gonna see how this works out. All right, guys, I'm late because I didn't get out here, but we're gonna see if we can get y'all some dope shots, some whips. Hopefully we can, we're gonna see. I got a long walk though, and I got a short period of time to do it in, so yeah, let's see what we can do. Okay, so a lot of people wanna know, what is WAM? WAM stands for We Are Mopar, and it's a really big Mopar event that you kinda don't wanna miss. It's one of the biggest Mopar events in the world. And if you drive one of these cars and you're an enthusiast, you wanna be here. You get great ideas and just get to see what's going on in the community. So I like to come out and I like to see events like this. But for now, let's check out some cars. I tell you one thing, what you wanna do is you wanna make sure you register your vehicle. I did, but I can't find my email. So I gotta park a mile away and then walk in. Kind of sucks, but it is what it is. Oh, that's nice. Look at that color. Look at that color scheme. That's dope. What's going on, brother? Hey, hey. What's the Instagram? SoClutch_78 Red Widow RT6. Look at this beautiful car. All carbon fiber. Look at that. God. Just when you think you did a lot to your car, you've done nothing. Look at the stripes. Look at the detail in the stripes. Ohio. I love this black and white two-tone, or black and carbon fiber two-tone. Same color as my wrap, just blue. follow Mod Effects. You've seen this car right here. Well done, well done. Another Mod Effects like that. party right in the middle of WAM. We're about to go to the WAM after event. It's pretty dope. The WAM stuff today was crazy, man. I wish I would have got there and had a chance to see more of it and do more of it. But, you know, I got to see a lot in 15 minutes. My thing is I wanted to make sure I showed y'all a lot of cars. Because there was just a lot. My bad. My compressors are filling in the back. You may hear them. You may not. But now I'm about to go to the car show. It's kind of like the after car show. I'm about to get ready to go to check it out. So stay tuned. Can't see me, it's dark. Let me explain what's going on. So they're saying that we're spectating, even though we're not spectating, we're just parked talking, because one or two people decide to do a donut and leave. They're saying that we're spectating, whatever that is. So they're either writing a ticket or taking people to jail. So, you know, what you're going to do is get a ticket, go to court, fight it, and go from there. You know, and it is what it is. People are trying to get out, but they're not getting out. They got locked up. They got that blocked off. They blocked off over there. They got everything blocked off. All right, let me get a rundown on what happened tonight so you can know. We were at Memorial Drive where we usually go hang out. We went there because there was a meet after WAM where a lot of people from like Houston and stuff was gonna go. The event got raided. They brought in semi-trucks to block it. They blocked the exits. They gave everybody a citation ticket or took people to jail. Okay. Let me explain what happened. Some people got out of there. Some people made it. If you got a citation ticket, it probably was $800. If you went to jail, your car was seized. Not towed, but seized. If you were a part of the police report, if you were a part of or fit the description of whoever was out here wilding and somebody called in, the car got seized. Reckless driving. I end up getting cool because I simply kept a cool head. Had a conversation with the officer.
Okay. They have every right to.
She was saying that they were spectating or something.
Yeah, it's an ordinance.
I'm just trying to get in line and get my ticket. People start acting stupid. They start taking me to jail.
Well, we've already started. Yeah. Nah, bro, I ain't gonna lie. This happens every weekend. Yeah. Are you from Houston too?
No, I'm from Dallas.
You're from Dallas?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I found out some cool facts about takeovers and things like this, or things like that in the city, so that you can make sure you're not a part of it. So trust me, you can be at a night event, minding your own business, simply there to look at cars and enjoy the atmosphere. Somebody can do a burnout, burn rubber, or takeoff. The police get called, and it'll get reported as a takeover. You don't want that problem, because you are a spectator to a takeover, and your car can get seized. So the officer did a good job explaining some things to do to prevent that. So they're not mad about the fact that we meet. They're mad about people who do dumb stuff at these meets. So in this event, the best thing for you to do, honestly, is to keep a cool head. Try to find an officer that's not already aggravated by dummies. You know, because dummies wilding out. What did I do? Why you gotta, what you want? Find you somebody that's not aggravated. Keep in mind that there are people, they are doing the job. They don't want to really be here half the time. They are just following orders. They want to go home. They want to stay safe. They're people still, right? Regardless of what we've been through with police, yada, yada, yada. Keep in mind that the best thing you can do in that situation is to remain calm, have a level head, talk to somebody. If you wasn't doing nothing, accept your ticket, fight it in court. You're probably going to get a chance to walk. If you could say, hey, we was there minding our business. This dummy started wilding out. You know, if you can go and say, yeah, that was the white car I seen, they'll more than likely be like, cool, we're not after you, we after him. Skate, that's what we wanted. We just need confirmation. So, I can't tell you how many times I've been at Mopar events and one dumb Mustang owner or one dumb Camaro owner or one dumb Mopar owner go do something stupid and it bring the heat on a bunch of guys and girls that just want to sit around and look at pretty rims and all this stuff. It's always some dummies that's just, their car usually ain't up to par and they don't know how to get attention at the event other than doing dumb stuff. So I feel like this is a situation we all can learn from. I feel like this is something we need to be aware of, because in the city of Dallas, in the state of Texas, mostly in the state of Texas,
Muscle cars got a bad rep. They just got a bad rep right now. And you want to make sure that you are, you understand the law and you understand your rights and you understand when it's time to leave or what you need to do to prevent yourself from being in a position where your car is seized. That's different from towing it. Towing it means you can get it out the impound tomorrow. You pay a little $200. You back on the road. Seizing it means you don't own it no more. I don't care what the bank, what you owe the bank. That's between you and the bank. Your car is going to the auction. And trust me, when I see a lot of cars get seized, I'm going to be at the auction trying to get me another Hellcat. So it is what it is. But make sure you are aware of the situation and the role you play in the situation. Having a cool head is the best thing you can do in a room full of dummies that's wilding out. Especially if you got stuff in your car, if you got whatever, you do not want to get to the point where they need to search and do all this stuff. You definitely want to do that. Also, another thing I learned in the city of Dallas, this only goes for a city ordinance. If you're driving with any lights on, it's illegal. Any lights. They can be white, they can be blue, black, flickering, fading. If you have lights under your car in the city of Dallas, wheel lights, undercarriage lights, anything on the front of your car that's not white, it is illegal. So a lot of times they don't message you about it because they don't care. That goes the same for a legal tint. However, they will use those items to pull you over if they feel like you're doing something. Those are items that usually lead to other things. They feel like, well, if you got lights on the front of your car and you got a really dark window, you obviously don't care about the law. You probably got something else. There's probably a good chance that they can pull you over and it can lead to a bigger arrest. This is just their way of thinking. It's not my way of thinking, but you need to be mindful of how they think about it so that you can know that if your tint is 5%, don't ride around with your dirty stuff in your whip. Stay clean. Keep a tag title and all that straight. If you're going to have it, you can have it. They probably never mess with you. But keep your junk legit if you're going to do it. All right, so we learned a lot today. But through my experience and my ability to capture it, I hope you were able to learn something from the situation. I didn't get a ticket because I cooperated and talked to him. Had a level head and didn't want to, you know, argue with him. And I understood and it was there to do a job. In fact, I went to the officer so I can make sure I was in line to get a ticket because I was near some knuckleheads that was about to get locked up simply because their attitude was jacked. And the officer literally was like, all right, I'm about to lock you up, you up, you up. Y'all pissing me off. Get over here. And I was like, let me go over here to this other officer because if they handed out tickets, let me get in the line for a ticket. I can go to court and fight that. I ain't trying to go to get my car seized. Seized. It's a big difference. I'm not trying to get my car seized. I'm not trying to go to jail on a holiday weekend and be in there until Tuesday and ain't backed up so you ain't getting out till Thursday. It's not happening for me, fam. So now you know. Share this video. Hit the subscribe button. There'll be a ton more. And hopefully it won't be all learning experiences, but hopefully more information about the car scene in the DFW area. Hit that subscribe button. I'll see y'all in the next video.